Dennis Wise and his daughters Jennifer and Carolyn want to see if they can survive the wild. Jennifer's engaged to be married, and Carolyn will soon be starting university. This may be the family's last chance to bond together.
One thing about it, with all this wood around here, we shouldn't have any problem finding enough wood to keep us warm.
The Wises have to trek 10 kilometers to reach a deserted fishing shack a few hundred meters from the sea.
I'll be glad, though, when we get off the sand.
Yeah, it's a little bit soft.
I've been camping since I was 1 year old, so I've got 52 years of experience of camping. This is going to be the ultimate experience for us. This is going to be a time where we get to share something very big. It's something I've always dreamed about and never thought would happen, and this is a dream that comes true.
They quickly come upon an indication of just how close to nature they'll be living.
Oh, my.
Oh, gross.
Whoa. That's a carcass of something.
What did this used to be?
Bear.
If this is a bear?
What kills a bear?
Man.
The Wise family will share Icy Bay with Alaska's largest population of brown bears, commonly known as grizzlies. More people are killed by bears in Alaska than anywhere else on Earth. Since 2000, bears have killed 6 people and mauled dozens more.
Look at the scrape marks.
Right in here?
Yeah, scrape marks and then bites. So something's feeding on it.
Is it open on the underside?
Yeah. Oh, we still got a little bit of sunshine left, so let's better find our cabin so that we don't end up running into whatever's eating on it.
Or whatever killed it.
The Wise family is 7 hours into their 10-kilometer hike, but they're still 1.5 kilometers shy of their destination, and Carolyn is struggling.
It's all right. Just keep moving.
Does my foot hurt?
No, it's my leg. I have a pulled muscle in my thigh.
Okay.
Every time I move it forward, it hurts.
It's been a long, hard walk today. At least we're on solid ground.
It helps some.
I know it does. Whoa. Cabin. Want to take your pack off?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do that. Take your pack off. We're right there, 100 yards, babe. Wow.
Go on in, girl.
I think it's gonna be a lot harder than I thought. I have never been one to back down from anything, and I'm not gonna stop just because I'm sore and tired. It's beautiful here and I love it, but it's gonna kick my ass or make me stronger.
The Wise family is living in an abandoned fishing cabin built in the 1960s. Like all the shelters, it has neither power nor running water.
I don't know if you guys could tell, but we're going through our food now. More peanuts. We have a couple for several months.
Each group has a small supply of food they'll have to make last for 3 months, but none of it provides much protein. They'll all have to hunt and fish to stay healthy.
I made a list of everything we have, and I'm gonna be checking it off as we use it so we know exactly how much left we have, and if a storm comes up, we'll have enough to get through it.
At the mouth of Icy Bay, the Wises have settled in. Dennis heads out in search of food.
Good luck, Dad. Bring us home some dinner.
I'll try my hardest. Be sure to lock the door behind me. Don't let any bears in.
The cabin is near a stream full of running salmon.
The salmon cycle is one of the most fascinating things to me there is, because they are born here in a little tributary, and they live in that stream for a couple years, and then they go all the way out down this glacier-fed river to the ocean, and then they live out in the ocean for a couple years, and then they come back to the exact same spot they were born in. And it's not long after they get to their spawning beds that they die.
With winter on the way, bears routinely congregate along rivers and streams, which are prime feeding grounds for them.
Bear tracks. Stay away, bears. Here I come. And that's what scares me the most. That's fresh. That's still wet. It hasn't been chewed over by the bugs or the eagles. There's been a bear here fishing very, very recently.
Seems like a good spot. Didn't take it.
Three people fishing would be better than one person. We're still new in the cabin right now, so it's not like they're slacking off. They're back at the cabin doing their share.
While Dennis is trying to provide for the family, Carolyn and Jenny are busy eating their way through the rations.
Peanut butter time!
I think this is our only peanut butter.
I don't care right now.
I'm putting up the canvas, Jenny.
It's good enough.
Are you saying that because you warped the head?
Yeah. Sectioning off part of the cabin that it doesn't have to be heated is gonna help us cut down on how much wood we need, and it's also gonna keep it a lot warmer in here.
Great, we've got a wall.
We've worked our butts off today. I say we veg. We'll veg until Dad comes back.
Yeah.
Another super peanut butter.
Hey, share it with me.
Carolyn and Jennifer Wise continue plowing their way through the limited food rations.
Jenny and I grew up eating just potato peels. We've had raw potatoes as snacks for a long time. And up here, we have plenty of potatoes.
I kind of like the idea of fried potatoes, but God knows this is faster.
Yeah, I like the idea of fried potatoes. I don't like the time.
Dang, he's a fighter. Come to Pop.
Dennis has hooked a silver salmon. These fish weigh between 3.5 and 5.5 kilos. Each kilo provides 1,900 calories, 270 grams of protein, and 80 grams of fat.
He's wrapped the line around something.
In this wilderness, every one of those grams is vital.
She's gone. It's very important to catch as many fish as we can in the short season. Pretty soon, they're gonna quit running, and they won't be available to us.
At the mouth of the bay, the hard work and close quarters are starting to take a toll on the Wise family.
So where do you suggest I put my rubber boots?
Right there, turning the other way. No, you can put your toes in and still see your
size. Okay, it was still the other way, I'm sorry. The other way.
It's not that hard to figure out, Dad. This isn't rocket science, okay?
The reason we're doing the organization of the cabin is that there's pretty heavy winds outside. It's rainy, wet, and we need to get more room to get wood in and just more organized in general.
You know, this way or this way, that chute takes up the exact same amount of floor space.
Yeah, but that's not how you had it, Dad. You had it like this, and guess what?
And then you took
up more space.
And then you told me to do it the other way, and
yeah,
I did it
like
that way.
Yeah, like that way, so it doesn't take up as much space. Okay, here, I'll show you the difference, because clearly you're not conceptualizing.
Wait, you had
it like this. I can't fit in as many shoes with your shoes like this.
And
you
said
put it like this.
You and you said the other. You said the other way.
I did not.
Just set them in there.
And I put them in.
Listen.
And I put them in like that. It was still the wrong way.
You keep your shoes wherever the you want. I'll do my own. There. More room for your shoes, Papa.
I moved them
so much more
another way. At a right
Both
angle.
Both of you, drop it!
It's the three of us all the time. And getting cooped up like that gets really stressful. And I think it's just, you know, they'll find anything they can to argue about.
And I did move it. It was a
Carolyn,
this way.
Don't cut me off. Incredibly right rude. You're the one who wants to act like an adult, right?
Last I checked, I wasn't the one that got into a screaming match over which way shoes were pointed.
I wasn't screaming until you butted your fat ass in.
The small confined space with just the three of us in a one-room cabin is very difficult. Neither one of them have had to share space, so it's a learning process for them.